Thank you for joining us to talk about using Google Scholar for research. We're going to talk today about how to use Google Scholar to help you find scholarly articles for your research and how to supplement that by using library resources. My name is Emily Scharf. My contact information is here, my email address, and we'll give you more ways to get help here at the end. So today we're going to talk about connecting Google Scholar to Webster University Library resources, looking at Google results to find the scholarly articles, and then the advantages to using scholarly articles in your research. So there's of course the temptation when we're doing research to Google our topic and find some information and then be done. There are definitely ways to find good information online, and we definitely don't want to discourage you from Googling your topic to learn more about it, to find some keywords to search, to use in your searches, to find some websites that you think that you can trust to get more information. Some of the sites that we have on here are official websites or government websites. There's also things that have books and things like that. So there are definitely there is definitely the opportunity to find some good information, and we'll talk in a little bit kind of the differences between Googling something, using Google Scholar, and using the library for your research. So we want to just encourage you to use Google Scholar when you're kind of getting started with your topic, looking for scholarly articles, and to, again, supplement the library's resources. So I'm going to go ahead and go out to Google Scholar and show you how to connect our library resources to Google Scholar. So if you are in the library in St. Louis or at another campus, sometimes this is going to happen automatically, but we want to go ahead and show you how to do this so that when you are at home using your own computer, you'll know. So this is the main page of Google Scholar. It's just scholar.google.com. And if you have a Google account and you're signed in, you can do this and you won't have to do it again. So over here on the left, there are these three lines to get to the menu. If I click on that, I'm going to want to choose Settings right here. And you'll see on the left-hand side here, there's an option called Library Links. So when you search for Webster University, you are going to find two options that you're going to want to click the little boxes and save. That's going to help you find the full text using Google Scholar. It's going to show you results that have our library's database's full text in there. So if I do my search, maybe I'm going to search for climate change. Similar to a normal Google search, it's going to give me some suggestions of what I might add to that search. And when I do the search, it's going to show me results that look a little bit different than when you're searching in our databases, because it is going to include both books from Google Books and then articles from lots of different places. So if you can access the full text, the PDF, that is going to be over here on the left side. It's going to show you that. And you've got some other options as well. It will give you a citation if you click on the little quotation marks, and it gives you those in lots of different styles. You can look at what other sources have cited the source that you are looking at, or you can do a search for related articles. Like in our databases, you can limit your search by date, and you've also got some other options. So if I go back to the menu, there is an advanced search. I can search for something by exact phrase. I can eliminate words from my search. I can search by author, by publication, and again, by date over there. So I want to just mention that you'll see in our first search here that we've got a couple things that we can access the full text right away, and that's no problem. but that is not always the case. So sometimes when you're using Google Scholar, it will ask you to pay for an article. We don't want you to do that. We are going to be able to get you articles free to you. So when you're looking at normal Google, you pretty much get everything, right? You get websites, you get pictures, you get all kinds of stuff. And for the most part, that is free. With Google Scholar, you're getting scholarly articles in your search results, books, conference papers, some legal things, but sometimes they're asking you to pay. If you're looking at the articles and databases from the library, you're getting a lot of the same things that you're getting with Google Scholar, and all of that is going to be free to you. Now, if you find something using Google Scholar, again, we can get it for you for free. So we want you to go ahead and, from our main library's homepage, under Find Resources, click on Specific Article. That is going to let you put in the pieces of a citation, and then we will request it from another library and get it for you. You can always ask a librarian to help you with this process, and when you do this, when you request an article from another library, it's going to take an average of 2 business days to get that to you. So again, make sure to start your research a little bit early, but please do not pay for articles. We'll get those for you for free. So if you've done some Google Scholar searching and maybe you've found some good stuff but you need a little bit more, you can also use the library's databases to find articles. So from the main library homepage, you're going to want to make sure that the big search box is on the Articles tab, and you're going to want to enter your topic there and click on Search. It'll have you log in with your last name and your Webster ID number, and then it will find you some articles. And if you need help with that, or with anything else, we'd love to help you. There's lots of ways to get in touch with a librarian. You can chat with us 24 hours. You can give us a call. You can visit us if you're in St. Louis. You can visit the library. We have a lot of other videos like this one on our YouTube page, and we'd love for you to visit us there and watch some more videos. Or you can email us. So again, please go ahead and use Google Scholar for your research, supplement it with our library databases, and if you need help finding articles or using any of the resources that I talked about today, please get in touch with us. Thank you.